In this example, we're looking for the final speed of an electron that's accelerating from the negative plate of a parallel plate capacitor to the positive plate through a known potential difference of 100 volts. So the intent with this problem is to use energy conservation to figure out the final speed of the electron. So I'm going to start by looking at what's the change in potential energy for the electron as it goes from the starting point to the finishing point. And that's given by Q times delta V. And the charge on the electron is negative 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs. And delta V is the final minus initial, so 100 volts minus 0 volts. When I run the numbers, I get negative 1.6 times 10 to the negative 17. And then I have coulombs times volts. Well, you have to remember that a volt is a joule per coulomb. And if I multiply by coulombs, I get joules. Okay, so I had a negative change in potential energy, which is good. The potential energy is going down. That's why the kinetic energy is going up. So my delta K is just going to be 1.6 times 10 to the negative 17 joules. Finally, I use the formula for kinetic energy to say, okay, the kinetic energy of a mass is 1 half mv squared. If I multiply by 2, divide by m, and square root both sides, I find that the speed is equal to 2k over m square rooted. So I plug in the kinetic energy of my electron, 1.6 times 10 to the negative 17 joules. And I plug in the mass of the electron, which you may need to look up. It's 9.11 times 10 to the negative 31 kilograms. And I get 5.93 times 10 to the sixth meters per second. In other words, about 6 million meters per second. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.